Bless you. My name is Minister Red. I'm the pastor here at Christ Our Life Ministries, located in Augusta, Georgia, on 308 Rose Street, directly behind the Walmart Lowe's on Bobby Jones Expressway, Interstate 520 heading west. I want to thank you for joining me for my Thursday night service, amen, along with my members, Brother Roland and his beautiful wife, Sister Brittany Pinson, Sister Selena, and her beautiful husband, Stan. I love y'all. Brother Minister Harvey Cole and his beautiful wife, Sister Kimberly. I love y'all. Amen. My brother Harry Evans, amen. I love you. The Peaches, I love you in the name of Jesus. I love my members. I love my members in the name of Jesus. And my sister, Sister Beverly Conyers Evans, who went home to be with the Lord on March the 4th of last year, that will never be forgotten. Every time I hold a church service, never to be forgotten in the name of Jesus. God bless you, Deacon Stevenson. I love you. Always here supporting your good friend. Hallelujah. God bless you, Sister King. I love you. Ready for Tuesday night in the name of Jesus. And this Thursday, and I'm already ready for Tuesday night. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus. Please join my sister church, Spirit of Liberties Ministries. They have services every Sunday morning at 8 a.m. and every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. And we'll be blessed this coming Tuesday night. Amen. With Sister King. Yeah, I'm going to put you on blast, Sister King. I'm putting you on blast. Sister King will be bringing the word Tuesday night for Spirit of Liberties Ministries. Y'all to join her and allow her to minister the word of God to you in a way that you'll be able to receive it. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus. I am on YouTube. I am on YouTube. There are over 400 messages on my YouTube channel. Y'all to join them and be blessed. Amen. Listen to them free of charge. Never asking you for any money and never will ask you for any money. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Today's message, tonight's message, the time of sorrow, because he knew through the Spirit. Because he knew through the Spirit the time of sorrow. Our verse of scripture tonight is Matthew 26 and 38. It reads on this wise, Jesus said unto his disciples, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry ye here and watch with me. Tarry ye here and watch with me. Why did he tell his disciples to tarry here and watch with him? It was because he knew through the Spirit that he was about to encounter deep distress caused by miserable situations. Jesus knew that he was in a time of sorrow. He knew it when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane. And the sad thing about it is, born again believers today don't even know it. And the entire world is our Garden of Gethsemane. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this awesome word tonight. We thank you for the audience. We thank you for those that's going to listen to this message on Facebook after I'm done teaching it, and on YouTube when I post it on the YouTube channel. God, we love you. It might be my voice that they recognize, and it might be my face that they know. But let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. It's in the mighty name of Jesus that we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you, Sister Erica Holloman. I love you. Thank you for joining me tonight. Hallelujah. Tonight's message, the time of sorrow, because he knew. On my board, I got, the time of sorrows has begun. The time of sorrows has begun. We're going to learn that in tonight's teaching. Hallelujah, the name of Jesus. Galatians 5:25 says, if we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Why must we walk in the Spirit if we live in the Spirit? Because it is through the Spirit that we know that the time of sorrows has begun. Hallelujah. Only those who live and walk in the Spirit will be able to have insight concerning the time of sorrow. Insight is a deep understanding of a thing, a deep understanding of a situation. It was the Spirit that led Jesus Christ into the Garden of Gethsemane and revealed to his soul the will of the Father that made his soul exceedingly sorrowful. And it was because he knew through the Spirit what the will of the Father had revealed to him that it brought deep distress upon his soulless life. Not on his spiritual life, but on his soulless life. I need you to catch that. Every sorrowful situation that you have is not coming to deal with you and your spirit man. It's coming to deal with your soulless man. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's look at this verse right here. In the name of Jesus. Psalms 34:18. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. He saves those who are crushed in spirit. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you, the time of sorrows has begun. And a lot of born-again believers are better get ready to have a crushed spirit. Not a destroyed spirit. Not a killed spirit. Just a crushed spirit. In the name of Jesus. It was the Spirit that led Christ into the Garden of Gethsemane and revealed to his soul the will of the Father that made his soul exceedingly sorrowful. God bless you, Pastor King. I love you, my friend. In the world today, believers don't appear to have a clue of the signs that Christ told us to be aware of that will usher us into the same situation that he found himself in when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane. Hallelujah. In the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus said to his disciple, he said, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful unto death. Tarry ye here and watch with me. When did he tell us this? When did he tell us this? Matthew chapter 24, verse 6 through 8. This is when he told us this in Matthew chapter 26, verse 4 through 8. He says, now, confirm to me if this is what's happening today, because the time of sorrows has begun. We are right now slap dab in the middle of Matthew chapter 26, 24, verse 6 to 8. God bless you, Valerie Lauren Robinson. I love you. I miss working with y'all. Amen. Matthew chapter 24, verse 6 to 8 reads on this wise. It says, and ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. Is that taking place today? See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Everybody talk like the end is here. The end ain't here. No. You know why the end is in there? Because everybody wants to miss the time of sorrow. Born again believers just think they're going to get raptured out of here. They just think they're going to miss the times of, if Jesus didn't miss the times of sorrows, you're not going to miss it. Pastor Red, not going to miss it. I was talking to Deacon Stevenson the other week, and amen. And I told him, I said, I can handle a lot of things, but man, I hate the feeling, the feeling of sorrowfulness. I hate to feel sorrow. I hate a deep distress caused by miserable situations. I hate that. But the time of sorrows has begun. But the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation. Is that happening? And kingdom against kingdom. Is that happening? And there shall be famines. I'm going to tell you something, man. You better look in pastors. You better look up. Man, New York was flooded. I mean, the United States, the weather is tying the United States up all over the place. All over the world. Stuff is happening. And earthquakes in diverse places. Here it is right there. This is what it tells us. All these are the beginning of sorrows. So if we got confirmation that all of this is happening, then that means the time of sorrows has begun. You can run from it. You can disagree with it. But it just hasn't caught up with some of us yet. But I promise you, it's going to catch up because the end is not yet. The end is not yet. You can't get to the end of something until you begin something. You got to begin something before you can get to the end of something. Hallelujah, the name of Jesus. Every situation, every circumstances in which a person or thing finds itself, every situation has a beginning. Some, if not many of them, are bad. But even in a bad situation, there's always a positive side, even if you can't see it yet. Even in a bad situation, oh yes, Sister Holloman, you got to start before you can finish. And everybody thinks that they're going to finish this Christian race happy. Like they're going to miss the time of sorrows. But if we're going to believe what Jesus says in Matthew 24:6-8, then we got to allow the Spirit to give us the insight to see that the time of sorrows has begun. But in every bad situation, there's always a positive side. Even if you can't see it yet, even if you do not have insight, even if you do not have a deep understanding of the situation that you find yourself in, there's always a positive side. And that is what Jesus, and that is why Jesus said, watch with me. You got to watch with him. You got to watch with Jesus. You got to watch with him. If you're not going to watch with him, then you ain't going to see it coming. You're not going to see it coming. But we see it coming through Matthew 24:6-8. But don't worry about that. I got it on the slide. We're going to get to why you don't see it coming. 1 Corinthians 10:13 reads on this watch. It says, no temptation, no situation has overtaken you except such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted beyond what you are able, but with the temptation, with the situation, will always make a way of escape that you may be able to bear it. Situations require prayer. Situations require prayer. That's why Jesus says, watch with me. Because even in a bad situation, there's always a positive side, even if you can't see it yet. So you got to pray your way out of it. In the name of Jesus. Many of the situations that usher believers into a time of sorrow are not being met with prayer. They're not being met with prayer. Because many saints believe Christ is going to rapture the church before the days of exceeding sorrowful events occur. That's what a lot of people believe. They think they're going to miss it. They think they're never going to see sorrow. I can tell you something right now. You think that all of them Jews, that them Hamas people killed and took hostage, you think that some of them weren't believers of Jesus Christ? I bet you they was. But I'm going to tell you right now, the nation of Israel is living in a world of exceedingly sorrowful events. And all everybody wants to do is attack Hamas, attack Iran, attack the Hezbollah. They want to, nobody's talking about praying. The old Jesus was telling his disciples, look, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful unto death. I need you to watch with me. I need you to tarry. I need you to tarry and watch with me, because the time of sorrows for my life has begun. I know it through the Spirit. I can see it through the Spirit. What can you see through the Spirit that perchance may could cause you exceedingly sorrowful events in your life? Can you see anything? Because if you can't see something, then that means you ain't caring and you ain't watching. Because I'm here to tell you tonight, exceedingly sorrowful events are about to occur. And it ain't no use to sitting up here and being quiet about it. Mordecai went through exceedingly sorrowful situations. Doggone Haman wanted to kill him and all the Jews. He wanted to kill him because he wouldn't bow down to him. You better not bow down to him. You better not bow down to him. Look what Psalm 16:4 says. It says, the sorrow of those who will increase, who run after other gods. Mordecai didn't do that. Mordecai didn't bow down to no Haman. But y'all bowing down to Haman. A bunch of people bowing down to Masonry and Eastern Star and NAACP, black, bowing down to everything. And then when they find themselves in exceedingly sorrowful situations, they do everything but pray. And Esther thought she was going to sit up in the king's house and think that she wasn't going to get touched. And Mordecai said, you ain't going to miss this. You're going to get it too. Esther sent back word to Mordecai, tell the people to fast for 3 days. Then I'm going to go in before the king and make my petition. You better pray and patiently wait for the word of God to move for you when you find yourself in an exceedingly sorrowful situation, because the time of sorrows has begun. Mordecai went through sorrowful situations. Job went through sorrowful situations. Don't act like y'all don't know the story of Job. Job went through sorrowful situations. Daniel went through sorrowful situations. Daniel went through it. He got thrown in the lion's den, but Daniel was praying. Daniel never stopped praying. Daniel never stopped praying. Paul went through exceedingly sorrowful situations. Paul went through exceedingly sorrowful situations. But what did they do? What did they do in them situations? What did Paul and Silas do when they was in prison at midnight? What did they do? You know, Peter had to be the sleepiest disciple that it was. You know, he slept on Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane. Then when Herod put him in jail, he was sleeping in jail. The angel had to kick him to make him get up. When he had loosed the shackles and Peter walked right out of the prison, unbeknownst to the guards, Peter still thought he was sleeping. Peter thought he was having a dream. And God was actually delivering this guy from prison. You know why? You know why? You know why God did that? You know why God did that while Peter was sleeping? I'm going to tell you why. Because Jesus told Peter something at the end of John. Jesus told Peter, God bless you, sister Spivey, I love you. Jesus told Peter, he said, Peter, lovest thou me? Feed my sheep. Said it to him three times. So even though Peter was sleeping, what's sleeping? A resting state where the mind is unconscious. I don't know what book is it. Resting, it is a resting state where the mind is unconscious. It is a resting state. Hallelujah, the name of Jesus. But Philippians 2 and 5 says, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Christ don't go to sleep. The mind of Christ don't go to sleep. Mind of Christ, that's why it says, tarry ye here and wait with me. Pray with me. Hallelujah. What did they do? You know, I didn't put Peter up here. Because I can't find the word where Peter was praying. But only when he went up on the rooftop, and the Bible didn't say he was praying, said he fell in a trance. And then the Lord spoke to him and told him to eat something. And Peter said, I ain't never ate nothing unclean. Still fighting the mind of Christ. And he was a disciple. The beginning of sorrows is here. Have you been praying through the Holy Spirit? Have you been praying through it? What you been doing? Just been listening to what's going on in the world? Listening to what's going on? Not listening to what's going on in Israel. Not listening to what's going on in Ukraine. I'm listening to what's going on in the world. Because if you're listening to what's going on in the world, then you'll understand that the beginning of sorrows is at hand. You know what's causing all them people to try to come over the border into the United States from Texas? The time of Matthew 24, 6 and 8 is what's causing them to come over that border. Hallelujah. Nation shall rise against nation. Kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes and famines. You know, that's hunger. Them people hungry, them people want to get out of South America. They want to get to the place that the United States called the land of the free, the home of the brave. The beginning of sorrows is here. But because it ain't touched you yet. Because it ain't touched you yet, you haven't been praying through the Holy Spirit about it. But don't worry about nothing, it's on the way. It is on the way. And you better hope you prayed up. You better hope you ain't sleeping. You better hope you ain't sleeping in the name of Jesus. Because the disciples didn't. The disciples didn't stay awake. Jesus came to his disciples and found them asleep. And he said to Peter, what could you not watch with me 1 hour? So what am I trying to tell you tonight? I mean, come on now. The time of sorrows has begun. I mean, can't you just give God 1 hour? Because you can get that football game 3 hours. You can get that basketball game 2.5 hours. You can get that baseball game all them hours. You can give your children's all types of hours. You can get them people you work with all types of hours. He only wanted 1 hour from Peter. Because he had told Peter, man, my soul is sorrowful. It's exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry ye here and watch with me. What is that telling us? That is telling us, at least we can definitely understand one thing. We can honestly, the way Jesus said this, we can honestly say that when he left to go, when he asked the disciples to watch and pray with him, and he went away, so that means if he comes back and says to Peter, what? Could you not watch with me 1 hour, Pastor King? Then that means we can take it and say, Jesus was only gone for 60 minutes. He was only over there talking to the Father for 60 minutes. Let's take it just the way he said it.
What?
Could you not walk with me 1 hour? So that means Jesus only went for 1 hour. And Peter and them fell asleep in 1 hour. They then fell asleep. And the man had told them, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death. Man, I don't care how exceedingly sorrowful your soul is. Man, I'm going to sleep, man. I'm tired. I ain't got the time to be praying with you. Man, it's, that your soul might be exceedingly sorrowful, but mine ain't. Could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray. That's the second time he had to say this. Watch and pray, lest you enter in the temptation. There we go. There we go. God bless you, Tone. I love you. Thank God for joining me tonight. Watch this right here. Watch and pray, lest you enter in the temptation. But let's go back to our slide then. Let's go back to it. No temptation, no situation has overtaken you except such as is common to man, but God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted if you'll stay awake and if you'll pray with him for 1 hour, because the time of sorrows has begun. God will not suffer you to be tempted beyond what you're able, but he will with the temptation, with the situation, make a way of escape for you. But y'all sleeping. We're sleeping. We're sleeping. I'm going to tell you something. If you go to bed at 10 o'clock tonight and you get up at 4 o'clock, it means 6 hours of sleep. If you didn't pray from 9 to 10, if you didn't pray for an hour before that, that means you got 7 hours of sleep. Where is that? Where is that 1 hour of prayer at? What is that 1 hour of prayer at? I'm gonna tell you what Pastor Red does. Y'all want me to tell you what Pastor Red does? Pastor Red got a prayer manual. Watch this. Pastor Red got a prayer manual. I just read them prayers out of their prayer manual for an hour. I got a thick prayer manual. I just read the prayers out of their prayer manual for an hour. I say, God, I don't know. I don't want to lean to my own understanding. I don't want to just throw some prayers up in the sky. So I'm gonna default, not lean to my own understanding. I'm gonna pick these prayers in this prayer manual that pray for Israel and the peace. I'm gonna pick these prayers that I think that what's happening in the world today, and I want to read these to you. And I'm not gonna allow the devil to say, yeah, you saying the same prayer every day. Yet Daniel did pray the same prayer every day. He prayed it for 21 days. I'm pretty sure Daniel was praying the same prayer. He wasn't changing up his prayer. Stop changing up your prayers. Just pray. Pray for 1 hour. You can do that. I just told you how to do it. Stop trying to look in your head to find prayer. Stop doing that. Make it easy on yourself. Go buy your prayer manual. You ain't got to do that. You can download an hour's worth of prayers from Facebook, from the internet. I'm trying to teach y'all how to have insight into what's happening, because we are in the time of sorrow. So what we got to do is we got to locate the places where the exceedingly sorrowful events are taking place, and we got to pray for these people, because that's what Jesus said. Jesus, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful unto them. Watch and pray with me. Watch and pray with me. See, the Israelites need us to pray for them. The Philistines need us to pray for them. The Ukrainians need us to pray for them. The Russians need us to pray for them. The Chinese need us to pray for them. Taiwan need us to pray for them. The Americans need us to pray for them. The Spanish trying to get over the border need us to pray for them. Watch and pray. My soul is exceedingly sorrowful unto them. Stop being a respecter of persons. Learn how to get the victory in prayer. Don't let the enemy make you think that you just reading a prayer from a book. No, I'm gonna tell you what the enemy got to shut us up. Now, when you read these prayers in this book, when you get this prayer manual, you pick out the prayers you want to read, and then you get a hour's worth of them. You gotta make sure they gotta be vocal though. They can't be you reading the book and you know, it has to be turned into words that has to be spoken into the atmosphere. You gotta speak the prayer into the atmosphere. Oh, y'all love to say go into the secret closet. Well, what do you think she's doing? What do you think the Bible's talking about going into your secret? It ain't talking about you going in there going to sleep. Situations require prayer. Sorrow, deep distress caused by miserable situations. Oh, I'm gonna tell you something. Pastor King, Deacon Stevenson, y'all, I'm gonna tell y'all what I'm gonna tell. Pastor Ren ain't in miserable situations right now. But somebody is, so I'm gonna pray for the people that are. And my God, I hope I don't have to see them. Because like I was talking to Deacon Stevenson, man, I hate when I find myself in sorrowful situations. Sister Erica Holloman, sister, don't you hate when the spirit of sorrow just overtakes your life? I hate it. I hate when the spirit of sorrow just engulfs me, and I just can't find a way to find happiness in some situations. And then if we tell it to people, we're not telling it to people for them to hear what we're having to say. We're telling it to people hoping that them people will remember to pray for us and not go back and talk about us and tell our business that we told them. Jesus says, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry and watch and pray with me. Tarry and watch and pray with me. The disciples didn't. They didn't watch within 1 hour. He said, watch and pray lest you end in the temptation. The spirit. But y'all want to run around and say you Holy Ghost filled. You want to say that. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. If you are not a believer who watches and prays with the Lord, then you are asleep and you need to wake up. If you are not a believer who watches and prays with the Lord for 1 hour, I give you 24 hours a day. I just want one of them, because you shall give Fox his hours. You shall give MSNBC its hours. You shall give ESPN its hours. You shall give Netflix its hours. You shall give Tyler Perry, the haves and the have-nots, you give them its hours. You shall give Woman Dawa Loose its hours. You shall give Madea its hours. Oh, you know what you do. You don't, man. If you are not a believer, oh, Sister Holloman, ouch. You better believe it. God was ouching me to death when he was giving me this message. He was ouching me to death. I'd be like, you want me to preach this message and you just tore me up? Because I know that I be giving ESPN them hours. I know I be giving TBS and TNT them hours. I know I be giving movies sometimes them hours. And then after I give them movies and that ESPN them hours, God ain't getting no, he ain't getting no 1 hour out of me. God ain't getting no 1 hour out of me after I done watched, sit up and watched 2 college football games back to back. You ain't getting no hour from me, God. I'm going to sleep now. Oh, I tried to tell y'all, Pastor Red to tell on himself. Pastor Red, don't worry, I got the slide coming. I got a slide coming that'll let you tell on yourself. If you are not a believer who watches and prays with the Lord, then you are asleep and you need to awake. Why? Because we are in Matthew 24, 6 and 8, the beginning of sorrows, sleeping. We are in the beginning of sorrows, sleeping. Oh yeah, Deacon Stevenson, I know, man. I know. Man, I'm gonna tell you, we lack insight. We lack insight. And the reason why we lack insight is because we are sleeping. We are in a resting state where the mind is unconscious. But we're saying we got the mind of Christ. The mind of Christ was never unconscious to the will of God, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. Jesus says, the end is not yet. All these are the beginning of sorrows. It will be a sorrowful thing. It will be a sorrowful thing. It will be a watch this. It will be a sorrow that nothing but death will be able to lift you out of. Watch this. Jesus says the end is not yet. All these are the beginning of sorrows. So when these sorrows start, it will be a sorrow that nothing but death will be able to lift you out of. You think I'm lying to you? Ask Cain. You think I'm lying to you? Ask Cain. Watch this, ready. Watch this. Watch this, ready. Genesis chapter 4, verses 11 through 15. God said to Cain, not to Cain to kill Abel. He says, Cain, you are cursed from the earth, which has opened her mouth to receive thy brother's blood from thy hand. When thou tillest the ground, it will not yield forth its fruit. It will not yield unto thee her strength. A fugitive and a vagabond shalt thou be in the earth. And Cain said unto the Lord, my punishment is too great that I can bear. Oh, this punishment is too great that I can bear. Behold, thou hast driven me out this day from the face of the earth, and from thy face shall I be hid, and I shall be a fugitive and a vagabond in the earth. Watch this right here. And it shall come to pass that everyone that findeth me shall slay me. Cain thought that this punishment was so great on Cain that he was exceedingly sorrowful, because he said, everybody that finds me is going to kill me. And then the Lord put Deacon Stevenson, Tone, Sister Holloman, Sister King, Sister Selena, God bless you. Thank you for Sister Valerie, Pastor King, Sister King. I mean, watch, he thought that when God, when he said anybody find him gonna kill him, he thought that was exceedingly sorrowful. Watch what God says that multiplies the exceedingly sorrowful. The Lord said unto him, therefore, whosoever slayeth Cain, vengeance shall be taken on him sevenfold. And the Lord set a mark upon Cain, meaning, no, the earth ain't going to yield itself to you. You ain't going to get nothing. You're going to be a vagabond. You're going to be a fugitive. And ain't nobody going to kill you. So, when the beginning of sorrows, after I get finished, the Lord said, after I get finished talking to you, Cain, you're going to experience the beginning of sorrows, and it will be a sorrow that nothing but death will be able to lift you from. But God won't let him die. And God won't let nobody kill him. The Lord set a mark upon Cain, lest any finding him should kill him. No, ain't nobody going to kill you. Ain't that's right, Tone. Ain't no easy way out. No, you're not getting out of this. You're not getting out of this. See, you might have killed Abel, and Abel had an easy death. Abel's death was actually easy. You're not getting no easy death. You're not getting no easy death until you do some suffering. Because you didn't do what I said. You're going to do some suffering because you didn't do what I said. Because all I asked asked you to do was pray with me for 1 hour. That's all I asked you to do. I told you my soul was exceedingly sorrowful unto death. All I want you to do is pray with me 1 hour. You don't want to pray with me 1 hour. You don't want to do that. Okay. All right. Again. You ain't going to miss the days of sorrows. You're not going to miss it. And you're not going to die either. You're going to experience sorrow. You know why Cain was going to experience this sorrow? I'm going to tell you why. Because Adam and Eve was still alive. In Adam and Eve, and when Cain turned into a fugitive and a vagabond, Cain took off. So not only was Adam and Eve sorrowful that they found their baby Abel dead, they didn't find their firstborn son that Eve said, "The Lord has blessed me and given me a man child." So Adam and Eve actually lost both their sons at the same time. And I know that made them feel exceedingly sorrowful that they were not able to see their children anymore. Now, I want to bring that home. Everybody on here probably except for Tone. Tone, you probably the only one on there that ain't a parent. But if you're a parent and you lost all of your children in one day, how sorrowful is that going to make you? Cain, no, you're not getting over. Ain't nobody going to kill you. You're going to experience sorrowful days. You're not getting over. You better hope you find the apple trees that's growing out there. Oh yeah, Deacon Stevenson, that would be devastating. That would be devastating. It would be devastating to me if Reggie and Ezra and my grandbabies all died in one day. Daddy babies, grandpa babies, devastating. The beginning of sorrows is the mark the world is about to receive. The beginning of sorrows is the mark the world is about to receive, and Christ's followers are sleeping. We're sleeping because we won't do, but I helped you tonight. I helped you tonight. I tell you this, after tonight, if you don't do what I've said, then that means that you've been sleeping on this message. I'm going to say again, do what I do. I don't want to, hear me now, I do not want to pray for 1 hour. I have no desire to pray for 1 hour. Can I be truthful with y'all tonight? When I get off work, I'm tired. When I get up in the morning, I'm tired. I have to find a way. I have to discipline myself in a way to where I must be able to obey what Christ has asked of me, not as a pastor, but as a born-again believer. Christ does not speak to me as Pastor Red. He does not do that. He speaks to me as Roderick Red, a water-baptized believer. That is how he talks to me. When I talk to y'all, I talk to y'all as Pastor Red. But God does not talk to me as Pastor Red. He does not do that. The beginning of sorrows is the mark the world is about to receive, and we are sleeping. If you have not been praying for 1 hour a day, you've been sleeping. You can say what you want to say. Disagree. I don't care. I'm going to follow the blueprint that Jesus told them disciples in that garden when he said, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death. Watch and tarry with me and watch. And he went away. And when he came back, Peter and the disciples were sleeping. And he said, what? Could you not pray with me for 1 hour? You couldn't pray with me for 1 hour. God said, I know them football games is tugging at you. I know them basketball games is tugging at you. How about you go on and give me the 1 hour? Because the football game is going to be 3 hours. Why don't you give me the 1 hour? You let the first quarter and half of the second quarter, let that, just miss that. You really want to catch the second half anyway. Why don't you give me the hour before the first half? Get the hour out the way. Then you can watch the rest of the game and the next game after that. But you then took care of the Father's business. Because you never know, because you never know, because y'all, for some unknown reason, y'all have mastered the fact that, you know, I better give 10% before I mess with the 90. See, y'all got that. You got that. But you ain't got the 1 hour before you enjoy the rest of your, of whatever it is you want to enjoy. That you know that after you get finished enjoying it, you're going to be tired as tired can be. I tell you, God talking to Roderick Rat. That's God talking to Roderick Rat. Okay. The mirror. Oh, you can fool us, but you can't fool the mirror. Yeah, you can fool us. Where my mirror at? You're not getting over. You're not getting over. Mm-mm. No, you can fool us. Oh yeah, Deacon Stevenson. The first fruits come early in the morning. They come early in the morning. Yes, they do. David says, in the morning you will hear my voice. Read Psalms chapter 5. Psalms chapter 5. I encourage you to let that be a prayer that you wake up to. You don't have to have it memorized. Do like, have it wrote down. Psalms chapter 5. Remember that. Psalms chapter 5. Hallelujah. Because only you know your sleeping habits. Only you know your sleeping habits. Only you and God. You can't hide. You can't hide. Only you know your sleeping habits. You know your sleeping habits. You know the resting state where your mind is unconscious to doing the will of God when it comes to praying for this world where the time of sorrows has begun. The time of sorrow. Because he knew through the Spirit that it was time for him to die. He knew that once he got finished praying, that Judas and them soldiers was coming to get him. He knew he was finna get the worst beating that any man has ever taken on planet Earth. He knew they was going to put a crown of thorns on his head. He knew they was going to mock him. He knew they was going to put a big piece of wood on his back. He knew they was going to make him walk it up a mountain. He knew they was going to nail him to it. He knew he was going to say, my Father, why hast thou forsaken me? And he knew he was going to die. He knew all of this. He knew it through the Spirit. And that is why his soul was exceedingly sorrowful unto death. God bless you, Bake. I love you, my cousin. Thank you for joining your cousin tonight. I love you. The time of sorrow, Jesus knew it because he was not asleep when the Holy Spirit spoke to him concerning what was going to happen to him when he went into that garden that night. And he asked God to remove that cup of sorrow. But he said, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. And all he asked his disciples, he didn't ask his disciples for 10% of their money. He didn't ask them to go out and sell some stupid chicken plates. He didn't ask them to go out there and buy a bunch of stupid Christmas presents for the children in the church. He didn't ask them to go out there and do a stupid fish fry to raise money for the stupid pastor and his stupid first lady wife's anniversary. He just asked them to watch and pray with him for 1 hour. I know y'all don't like the way I say that. But I'm telling you, churches today doing stupid stuff. The pastors is in them dumb deacons got church people doing stupid stuff that they put in front of prayer. Prayer is what the entire world needs, because exceedingly sorrowful days are at hand. And we too busy trying to address issues to keep people happy when it's impossible to do that in the time of sorrows. If Jesus is going to tell us that it is the beginning of sorrows, there is nothing we can do to delay that sorrow from happening. And we're going to read again Matthew 24, 6 through 8, so we'll make sure we understand it. Ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled. Don't let that trouble you. Mm-mm. For all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. See, all the wars and rumors. See, you should hear of wars and rumors. It's a, you're just going to hear about these things. You're just going to hear about it. Oh, don't be troubled by that. Oh, no. Mm-mm. But when nation rises against nation, that means the war. You don't have to worry about the rumors. Because once a nation rises against a nation, that means the wars are here. You got to be able to understand the difference between verse 6 and verse 7 here. You got to understand what he said. When you're hearing them talking about, you know, that we're going to invade you, we're going to attack you, when you're out, don't let that trouble you. They're just talking. Oh, but when they actually rise against the nation and the kingdom against the kingdom, and then the famine start. You know where the famine start? Because the wars cause the famine. You know why the pestilences start? Because the wars cause the pestilences. You know why the earthquake? What? Because they're putting so many bombs into the city that it's impacting the earth underneath the ground, so it's causing the layers of the ground to shift. You think you're just gonna drop a bunch of bombs on the ground and it's not causing the shifting in the ground that's gonna cause the earth to begin to quake? And you're gonna have earthquakes in diverse places. All of these are the beginning of sorrows. All of them. The beginning of sorrows. And all we want to do is, and like our dumb president the other night on 60 Minutes, the guy says, do you think that the United States can fund both the Ukraine and the Israeli war? This idiot. I'm a, yeah, idiot. says, yes, we are the United States of America. We are the greatest nation on planet Earth. Yes, we can fund. No, you can't, because you got a stupid Congress that won't even elect a Speaker of the House to make the decisions to even do anything. And you sitting up there talking, and your Congress is divided. And you giving Iran $6 billion for some hostages. That you don't got $6 billion. All you got is Deacon Stevenson, Tone, my cousin Babe, Sister Valerie, Pastor King, Sister Selena, Sister King, Sister Erica Holloman. All you got is their tax money. And you want to say that we can fund it. And the United States is the most in debt country. And I'm going to tell you something right now. We are not far from being third world country. We are not far from other nations coming up with a currency that's going to wipe out the American dollar. And then when that American dollar gets wiped out, your souls are going to be exceedingly sorrowful, because I don't care how much money you got in the bank, I don't care how much you got saved up, your money will be worth nothing. But you don't care. We still running around and we happy. Ain't nothing touched us yet. But I'm gonna tell you something right now. The hurricane starts out in the middle of the ocean. Hurricanes don't start on land. They start in the middle of the ocean. And then by the time they hit land, the people are filled with exceedingly sorrowful feelings because that hurricane done destroyed them. I tell you, everything that's taking place around the world is a hurricane. It's a hurricane, and it's about to, in the impact of it, the United States economy is going to feel it. And you got people that call themselves Christians sleeping, and they don't care what's going on around the world, because the United States is still functioning perfectly. But Satan's hurricane is on the way. It is on the way. Oh, it's on the way. And I'm gonna tell you, that's why when I was talking to Deacon Stevenson, I was telling him, I was like, man, I do not feel like dealing with sorrow. I do not feel like dealing with it. I'm doing nothing to, I'm doing everything I'm supposed to do. I'm being obedient. I'm taking care of my family. I'm making wise decisions based off of the word of God. But still, I'm going to feel sorrowful situations, because did not Jesus do that? What did Jesus do wrong? Jesus did nothing wrong. He did nothing wrong. But yet, he told them disciples, my soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry and watch with me. And they did not do it. And ain't nobody in the United States thinking about nothing. They more focused on some stupid criminal charges against Donald Trump than they are about what's going on in the world. T.D. Jakes is more interested in making stupid Thou Art Loose movies. Jamal Bryan more interested in trying to show gay churches that God approves of them. Joel Osteen out there steadily teaching against the doctrine of Jesus Christ. In the church, and all we're doing is looking at it and saying nothing. The hurricane of sorrows is on the way. I don't care if you don't believe nothing I've said tonight. I really don't care. Because I'm going to tell you what Jesus says. I'm going to go back to what he says. Jesus says, watch with me. You can watch. Make sure, not you now, make sure you go and watch a movie with your wife or your husband. Go watch a movie with your friends. Go watch a football game with somebody. Go watch your children play football games and basketball games and baseball games in high school. Yeah, go and watch it. And it's okay to do that. But you better add a watch with Jesus into your day. God bless you, Elder Tramell Hill. I love you. You better add an hour's worth of watching with Jesus in your day. He will honor that. That widow woman was exceedingly sorrowful. When the man of God came up, he said, what are you going to do with that meal? Well, I'm going to gather me some sticks. Then I'm going to make me a fire. And then I'm going to bake two cakes. And then me and my son, we're going to eat these cakes. And then we're going to die. Now, as she was telling me this, I bet you she was filled with exceedingly sorrowful. But because she had a man of God there, a man of God that prayed and watched and tarried with Christ. And he said, no, you bake me a cake, lady. And the cruise of oil will never stop coming out of that barrel, and your flour ain't never going nowhere, lady. I'm finna pull you out of that sorrowful situation that you're in. Because God has heard your prayers. The only way that I know that God heard this lady's prayer was because when the raven stopped feeding Elijah, God said, I want you to go down to Zarephath. There is a widow woman that's going to sustain you. How in the world did this widow woman get the awesome privilege to be visited by Elisha? She must have been tarrying and watching and praying to God that her alms, like Cornelius's, must have came up before God. And just like God sent Peter to Cornelius, God sent Elisha to the widow woman. Now, when the days of sorrow occur in your life, make sure now you remember this message. And then I want you to ask yourself, why nobody has came yet? The Bible says, he that will come shall come and will not tarry. Let's look at my saying again. Every situation has a beginning. Some, if not many of them, are bad. But even in a bad situation, there's always a positive side. Even if you can't see it, where the woman couldn't see it. She couldn't see nothing but them, that little meal and them two cakes. And that is why Jesus said, watch with me. Oh, please watch with him. Please watch with him. Thank you for joining me tonight. Let us pray. Father, we all guilty. Father, in the name of Jesus, we all guilty. We know the magnitude of our watch. We know the magnitude of our watch. Pastor King and everybody else listening to me tonight don't know how much I watch with you, but I know how much I watch with you. Lord, thank you for being merciful enough to allow us to hear such a message as this, to give us the opportunity to turn from our wicked ways so that you can hear from heaven, forgive our sins, and heal our land. God, we love you. Thank you for this message. Thank you for my audience. Thank you for those that's going to hear this later on Facebook or on YouTube. God, we love you. And God, we are. Thank you for the insight into knowing that we are in the beginning of sorrows. Thank you, Lord, for this word. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen and amen. Thank y'all for joining me tonight. I will see you Sunday morning with Pastor King at 8 a.m. Then I will be back before you Sunday at 11 a.m. with another word from God. I hope that by the time you get to me on Sunday at 11 a.m. that you will have taken my advice and found you a prayer book. You could just read Psalms. You could just read Psalms for 1 hour. Challenge yourself. Challenge yourself to spend an hour with the Lord in prayer. Challenge yourself. I love every last one of you. God bless you. Amen and amen.